Destiny, Rise of Iron, how to get the Khovostov. Anyway, the Khovostov is the most versatile weapon, well, in the exotic form. But anyway, this is going to be how to get it. Anyway, first, you kick off the quest by dismantling your old Khovostov, or going ahead and going and killing one of the hive wizards that are going around in the plague lands and hopefully get an intel relay. Then use it go towards the divide from when you're coming to the rocky yards, it'll be to your left, and go into there, and you go all the way to the far end of the room, you'll see a little monitor, insert that, go into the falling catch, and if there is a servitor there, destroy the servitor, and go to the chest on the far right corner, and collect the schematics. After you get the schematics, you gotta go get the weapon blueprints and weapon parts. Blueprints, you just gotta kill a bunch of adds. Weapon parts, there's three weapon parts in the plague lands. One of the parts is in, if you played the Spinkus Perfected Strike, you'll know where it is. It's basically where that little small monitor is, where you have to go ahead and pick it up. And, other than that, you go to the blast area where you fight off that huge fallen walker, or an ogre, and you go over there on the first building you ever see when you go into that section, go on there, search around. There's gonna be one. It'll light up on your your HUD. Then also that's all the weapon parts and stuff. You just gotta claim it to Shiro and do this quest. Story mission called the Khovostov Rising. You have to take out a captain for the last part, which is like the muzzle. But the thing is that the captain, when you first encountered him, he teleported away. Now you need to take him out again in the end of the story mission. And also be careful on getting yourself killed because of the fact all the fallen ships and their grenades. I've done that once. This is actually footage after I got the Khovostov. I'm just doing the story mission all over again to show you. And basically, you kill the captain, then your ghost gets a little bit of nostalgia and goes and wants to chat with you. And you gotta go all the way to the fallen catch where you killed that servitor and or get the schematics if you didn't have the old Khovostov. And when I mean the old Khovostov, it's the common version. Anyway, first opinion time. Man, this thing is overpowered, for PvP and PvE. Why? Because it's versatility, it's full auto, burst fire, and semi-auto. Just gotta select the perk. It's high rate of fire and mid fire rate. One thing is for sure, I will not use the semi-auto version, because, it just doesn't feel like a good old scout rifle, like how it should be, but... And also with the low rate of fire pulse rifle, it doesn't feel like a pulse rifle. It's just like pow 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 instead of like that. So high rate of fire is mostly good for PvP. Like you have full auto, extended mag, and small bore. Not sure, but something that increases the stability on the gun. And extended magazine and 900 round per minute, boom, you have the Doctrine of Passing in your hands right there. And you don't have to do the trials. Then also about the Khovostov is when you use the burst fire in the same combination, you get the Grasp of Malik, which is another overpowered high rate of fire weapon. The scout rifle, the semi-auto part of it is not that great, but at least it has that version. You need range sometimes. But one thing is for sure, it's good, and it spawns at 350 lights, so even if you don't like it, you can just go ahead and and infuse it and go into the how do you call it, the blueprints, and go ahead and buy it from there if you ever wanted to use it again. And yeah, that's if you don't like it, which is very doubtful on this side, because this weapon is just so cool, and also the shaders are pretty cool. The Last Warmind is my favorite, but then also there's the Beru of Aeronautics, which is like a Cosmodrome-like theme. And, yeah, other than that, even the default looks so cool. Like it makes it look like a good old AK-47. And, yeah. Also, the sights, you have the classic sight, which is all cracked and damaged, like, from the first time you ever grabbed the thing. And also, the new one, which is, well, all refurbished, but a little bit more zoom, aka less stability and range. Okay. And now, on to why was it so hyped about. It's the first gun you ever get in the game. Okay. Who wants to have the first gun ever you ever get, but remodeled into an exotic weapon? Yeah, now that's just awesome. They're like basically the Reservoir is like the return of the year one weapons, like the Khovostov, the Yalohorn, the Thorn is also coming back. But yeah, other than that, this is one of the weapon quests you do for the little blue book achievement on the, when you go into your progress menu, and all the way on the top left corner, you know, it's a huge book, it says Rise of Iron, and that's one of the weapon quests on there. The other one's the Yalohorn, I think the other one's Thorn, I think, and I don't know what else. But anyway, smack that like button, hit the sub, drop a comment, and I'll see you guys later for another video on my channel. I'm out of here. I feel like I made the right choice. We should let Shiro know how it went out here. Let him admire his handiwork. And thanks.